Hello friends, this is another lecture on Bessel's function. In this lecture, we will study some basic theorems and basic questions based on this particular phenomena. In the previous lecture, you have studied how to find the Bessel's function. We can find Bessel's function by the series solution of Bessel's equation. That is, what is the Bessel's equation? X square d2y over dx square plus x dy over dx plus x square minus n square y is equals to 0. And here regular singular point exists, so on regular singular point we can apply Frobenius method, and after applying Frobenius method we can get the series solution of the Bessel's equation, and the series solution is known as Bessel's function, and it is represented by Jnx. This is the series solution of the Bessel's function. And in this particular case, a naught is replaced by 1 upon 2 raised to power n gamma n plus 1. So here we are taking one problem, proved that j half x is equals to square root of 2 upon pi x sin x, and j minus half x is equals to square root of 2 upon pi x cos x. So for this, we are taking a Bessel's function in term of series. So jnx is equals to x raised to power n upon 2 raised to power n gamma n plus 1. 1 minus x square upon 2 into 2 n plus 1 plus x raised to power 4 upon 2 into 4 into 2 square n plus 1 n plus 2 and so on. So here, if we let it is equation number 1. Now, putting n equals to 1 by 2. So j 1 by 2 x is equals to x raised to power 1 by 2 upon 2 raised to power 1 by 2 gamma 1 by 2 plus 1. 1 minus x square upon 2 into 2 1 by 2 plus 1 plus x raised to power 4 upon 2 into 4 into 2 square 1 by 2 plus 1 1 by 2 plus 2 and so on. Or this is root x, this is square root 2, and gamma half plus 1, that is gamma n plus 1, can be replaced by n gamma n. So we can replace it by half gamma half. 1 minus x square upon 2 into 2 into 3 by 2 plus x raised to power 4 upon 2 into 4 into 2 square 3 by 2 into 5 by 2 and so on. Or gamma half is equals to, what is the value of gamma half? Root pi. So this 2 will be in the numerator. So 2 root x upon root 2 root pi, and 1 minus x square upon 2 into 3 plus x raised to power 4 upon this 2 cancelled, that is 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 and so on. So we can write it as root 2 root x upon root pi. 1 minus x square upon 3 factorial plus x raised to power 4 upon 5 factorial and so on. But for the sin x, the expansion of the sin x is equals to x minus x cube upon 3 factorial plus x raised to power 5 upon 5 factorial and so on. That is, we have to multiply by x to the entire function. And only we cannot multiply by x. We have to divide by x also. So, multiplying and dividing by x to the numerator and denominator. So, this x is taken outside and the multiplication of x is taken inside the bracket. So x minus x cube upon 3 factorial plus x raised to power 5 upon 5 factorial and so on. And this root x cancels this x by root x. So j 1 by 2 x is equals to square root of 2 upon pi x sin x. So this is root. Again, if we replace n by minus 1 by 2, then by the entire this same process, we can get the value of j minus half x is equals to square root 2 upon pi x cos x. So, it can be solved by yourself. Prove that j minus nx is equals to minus 1 power n j nx. So, for the solution part, we have from j minus x is equals to sigma r equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma minus n plus r plus 1 x by 2 power minus n plus 2r. Now we have to change this negative into the positive to get the value of jnx. So what to do? We can replace this summation in the two summation form, that is sigma r equals to 0 to n minus 1 and plus sigma r equals to n to infinite, that is minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma minus n plus r plus 1 x by 2 power minus n plus 2r, same as minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma minus 1 minus n plus r plus 1 x by 2 power minus n plus 2r, and this is we have to find n is equals to positive integer. So in this particular case, since n is a positive integer, so this function is not valid for the negative integer, and by this limit this is entire is of negative integer, so this will be 0. So 0 plus sigma r equals to n to infinite minus 1 power r upon r factorial gamma minus r plus r plus 1 x by 2 power minus n plus 2r. Now we have to change the summation. The limit is from 0 to infinite, but this is r equals to n, so we have to change this r by n plus something. That is, if we put r is equals to n plus k, then from here k will be equals to 0. So j minus n x is equals to sigma k is equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power n plus k upon n plus k factorial gamma minus n plus k plus 1 x by 2 power minus n plus 2n plus 2k, or we can write it as sigma k equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power n into minus 1 power k upon this n plus k factorial can be replaced as gamma n plus k plus 1, and this is gamma k plus 1, or we can rewrite it as k factorial, and this is x by 2 power n plus 2. Now this minus 1 power n can be taken outside the summation, because summation is valid only for k. So we can write j minus nx is equals to minus 1 power n sigma k equals to 0 to infinite minus 1 power k upon k factorial gamma n plus k plus 1 x by 2 power n plus 2k. Now here, if we replace r by k or p or s or any other term, this j minus nx or jnx have no any effect, because this is based on n and x. So here we have replaced k by r by k, so there is no effect. This is entirely the value of jnx, and this is the proof which we have to find. Hope you understand the content of this particular lecture. If you like this lecture, then like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.